Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, or if you are new here, hello! So as you've gathered by the title and the thumbnail, I am going to be doing the alphabetical makeup challenge. Saw this just recently by Nikki Tutorials, in fact tonight being a Sunday night when I was watching it on YouTube, I saw it and I thought this actually is a really fun idea. I do have another video idea as well, which I'll either do it later on, depending on how long it takes me to not only get through this, but also how long it takes me to edit it as well. So, alphabetical order challenges obviously list from A to Z, and some parts of the alphabet don't actually require anything to do with the face, but there are other things that do. So, one way or another, you're still going to wind up, I kind of like doing another version of the backwards or reverse makeup challenge, double reverse. So I have listed in my phone, my sister got me this phone case too, kind of like a snow globe but in a phone case type of thing. Okay, so A, for the letter A, there is nothing that you can think of really. B is bronzer, blush and brows. C, contour, crease. There isn't anything for D. E, eyeliner, eyeshadow, all aspects. F, false lashes and of course foundation. G, this was just a random add-in that I put in that I thought of as I was jotting all this down. I was also watching Nikki's video, but when she got up to this step I thought, oh yeah, what? I'm gonna have to shut this door. I'm sorry, I'll be right back. The studio door, well it's technically called an attic, but we call it a studio. So it was just a bit of a random add-in, but under G, which I think is actually properly packed away. I don't know where it is, so I'm just going to get rid of that. But under G is gloss. Hopefully I can find one. H, of course, highlighter. Like that was the one thing I was forgetting. And then when Nikki mentioned it in her video, I'm like, oh yeah, duh. I, J, K, there's nothing. L, lipstick, liquid or cream or regular. Here it's the regular lipstick. Kind of like a Gigi Hadid one or EXO Beauty. And lip liner, of course. M, of course, mascara. And O, there's nothing for that. P, of course, powder. I don't have setting spray or primer, so those two I will technically be passing on, or skipping out on, I should say. So let's start off with B, which is my first step, which is going to be bronzer. And this is also the way that I have written it in my phone, in my notes. For bronzer, I'm always using the AC on Tour palette. Well, my sister-in-law actually got me this. Most of it just broke, but the and now my cat is fighting to get in. I haven't even started on the makeup yet. As I was saying, like, what's going to interrupt next? The ghost? That would actually be pretty cool, and I want to catch it on camera. Just saying. Most of the nude shades from this palette just decided to break, but luckily there is one more nude shade there that I don't even use, but there are still two other bronze shades that I'm going to use. I'm just going to use my bronzer brush. Can also be used as a contouring brush, which still had a crap ton of powder on it apparently. Sorry about the beeps, it's part of my dad's computer. Kind of sounds like an AI or whatever. Alright, so I'm going to be taking some bronzer. Taking this one because it has got subtle grey tones in it. I'm not going to be too shy about this either because obviously I'll be going in with foundation. And I do want to make sure that the powder sits through the foundation while my own hair is sticking out. And don't mind how muddy and ridiculous this is going to look. For the most part, this whole look is going to look ridiculous, although Nikki and James, because I also just watched James Charles' version. I do currently have the tutorial where he does Dinner Marbles makeup, but I don't have my laptop in here. It's going to be for another video. So I watched both their videos and super funny. It's very, very, very similar to the makeup in reverse challenge. And don't mind the blunt cut sort of sticking out. That video where I did recut my hair, I was using material cutting scissors. I intentionally went out to buy some proper hair cutting scissors, but the store that I was at didn't have any. So I thought it was rude and helped no one. Or as I'm always saying, helps no one. Okay, I know I'm looking so ridiculous, but again, it's will eventually be covered with foundation, I meant. So in my hair cutting video, I look like I'm struggling epically with the the scissors, the material cutting scissors, which yes, it wasn't easy to grip, but I definitely had a good eye. It was just a matter of the angle. From now on, I'm just going to cut with my palm facing upwards, not my this part of your hand, not the palm, the top of your hand I meant. That way I'm still cutting my hair as though someone else was cutting my hair. The cut saw worked out really well. And my hair is getting much, much fuller. Pretty sure this is a cockroach. Or cricket, whatever they're called. Lived in Australia all my life and I still don't know my insects. Not my fault. Not my fault, some of them sound alike. It is bronzer done. Bronzer can also be used as contour. Next up is blush. Blush, I'm always going in with the Remix palette and taking Bestie. It's quite the pigmented shade. I'm going to be making myself look ridiculous for quite some time. I'm just going to put a very, very light amount of foundation over. And technically all the background sounds, except that beeping, like the robotical beeping. Pretty much all background sounds will be concealed by the background music that I've been playing. The overlay music. Background music, whatever you want to call it. I'm pretty sure I just called it twice now. Okay, that is blush. Now for brows. So for my brows, same story as always. Going with my ABH Deep Brow Pomade in Chocolate and use my Exo Beauty Grimmer Brush. It's the only brow thing I have and the only grimmer brush that I have. I still haven't shaved my brows off yet. I haven't really been bothered or... I mean, I will eventually because I still like the idea of shaving off my brows and drawing on different style of brows. Depends on what I'm feeling. All this packing and staging our house. Like, I have to keep shifting my bed back into the middle of the room. But because it's Meals on Wheels, my bed is on wheels by the bed frame. To sleep on it and just to generally chill out on it, I push it up against the wall, which is right against my window. And we've got inspections. I just stick it back into the middle with the headboard, which is separate. Take off my blankets and stick them in the high point of my closet, and place back the two pillows. One, they're both burgundy, but one says Vinivera on it, which is French for dream, according to the stylist. The two stylists, one who looks like she's right into fitness, and the other one who looks like she could be booking in a salon. As those two are done, let's see, which is contour and crease. Fortunately though, my contour shade broke out. I pretty much already did contour, but I'm gonna go back in again because that's the next step. Going to take, I'm sure that one of these Kristen Dominic's palettes has a greyish tone, so I'm going to take Toasted, which is a grey toned brown. And is that a contour? Hopefully it works out as a contour as well. Well, that's awkward. I know that on the camera looks super harsh, but in person, it's actually not so bad. Okay, that is contour and crease. Just a shade for my crease. Okay, I'm going to take something subtle. I'm going to take Soft and Sweet, the second Dominic Cosmetics palette, which is the Berries and Cream one. I'm leaning back, so I'm sorry if I am a bit blurry. I am the Trap King, baby. Okay, even with the ring light on, I'm still looking quite dark in person. Lighting dark, not makeup dark, whatever. I take some of Cherry Juice. And that's going to the crease as well. I almost got a bit ahead of myself, but then I realised what I was doing. Just apply this into the crease. Just into a very opaque shade. Not when it's combined with something anyway. Except when that happens, it does become opaque. Awkward! Beeping, shut up. Even though it won't, because it's plugged in. It's crease done. Now for E, because D doesn't have anything. E is eyeliner. I'm going to take my Gigi Hadid liquid precision liner. You are wondering what I'm drinking. I'm just drinking Up and Go. That was the wrong hour. James and Nikki's video, they're both blaming themselves having to do false lashes first. Anyway, because I intend to do a Instagram video after this, I gotta lean forward so you guys can see in clear quality. With a fitness video I posted, but well, by the time you're watching this, the fitness video is already available. But I am to do another video, but the audio was a fail. It worked, but not the way I wanted it to. I ended up having to delete the raw footage of my fitness video so I can make sure that I can make room for the new footage coming in. Sometimes I do have that issue with my sister's hard drive and my computer, where it just complains out of nowhere. So even when I did delete all that footage and learned the hard way that the audio system was just a fail, I used it properly, but the sound waves were just picking up my breath. So note to yourself, have the guard up. It just creates a barrier for your breath. I deleted all that footage for nothing, and then the second video that I was working on was also a fail. I had to redo that one, and I completely realised that with this fitness video I hadn't made an Instagram video out of it, so I'm going to have to screen record my own video and then take little clips out of it, create a whole new video. Okay, so I messed up like the tiniest bit, but I'm just gonna waste that dryer so I can flick it away. Until then, eyeliner is done. Now for some more eyeshadow. All aspects, so that means all parts of the eye now. I'm going to take some of Sugar Cookie, which is this shimmery sparkly shade here, which is like the shimmery version. Which is like the shimmery version of Sweet Cream. So the shimmer shadow ended up covering up that mistake, so never mind. Right, now for under eye shadow, take the chocolate mousse. That might be a bit bold, this choice, but I'm going for it anyway. Okay, so all aspects of eyeshadow is not done. I am still yet to do my brow bone. And in a corner as well. Okay, now all aspects of eyeshadow is done. False lashes. Right, so first of all, where did my glue go? I thought that it actually rolled down a hole in this because these floorboards usually have holes in them due to the woodcut. And I thought that the glue had fallen down one of the holes. It didn't. The bottom here. I don't know if I want to go in with something. Oh, well, my singular pair of romantic ones. One's a bit too short than the other. I'm going to go in with the Heiress from the Natural Stack. It's not a palette, it's a stack. I'll wait till this dries and stick them on. And now for the other side. Could have sounded better, but I was also too busy sighing. False lash is done. Time to take off some foundation. I have a bit of a concoction, mostly because one is way too pale for me and the other one is way too dark for me. Being a natural beige and porcelain together, obviously on a beauty blender. I'm going to use a very little amount, the best I can. Okay, I'm just going to dab it on my hand first. The goal is to put the majority of the foundation on the parts that have not been touched just yet, and then whatever's left on the sponge to go over that. For gloss. I don't know where my makeup box is. So I'm going to have to skip over gloss and it'll take me way too long to find anyway. Up next is a highlighter, H. Right in front of me, I've been using the mirror for it. For my highlighter, whilst my foundation isn't wet but it isn't all the way dry, I'm going to take some of Aurora. Stick a little bit more of a beam out of that. I am going to go in with Macchiato from the original Kristen Dominguez palette. It is specifically an eyeshadow, but of course you can use it as a highlighter. Obviously what I'm doing. Highlighter done. Now for lipstick. So first I'm going to take on some lip liner. Taking Holly from EXO Beauty. Tracy. Now lip liner that's done. For my lipstick, I'm actually going to go in with a cream product. I'm going to play around with my ABH Lip Primer Palette. Taking this shade up the top here, combined with this nude shade here. I should have just gone from the corners and inwards. Oh well. That is lipstick. For mascara. Okay, that's mascara done. Now for the last step for me anyway is powder. So I'm gonna take my matte maker from, what are you from? Maybelline, I kept thinking it was Rimmel. That's a foundation that's long since dry now. Okay, so this is the finished look. Gosh, my own hair is sticking out. Hopefully I'm in better focus, but this is now the completed look. So it does not look that bad at all, which is good. I mean, considering there are ways to work around how to disguise such really bad contour, given that was pretty much the first step for anyone really. Once again, feeling a lot like Jenna Marbles. I don't have as bold and dark as makeup this time. But like with my upside down makeup challenge, I just went up looking, making myself like Jenna Marbles back in her bleached hair days. So this was my full face of makeup done in alphabetical order. I really, really like how it came out. I'm not disappointed. Nothing's too harsh or unblended or just not natural. So thank you all so much for watching, and I shall see you all in my future videos. Bye-bye.